a bad day of lifting is always better than a good day at work, and I think that's pretty good. So again, if any of you guys have had a bad competition or it didn't live up to your expectations, first of all, it's never going to. up until the day before, TMI, but I had started to get my period, which happens a lot when I'm in a big time of stress. I think my body just kind of freaks out, and it's like, you know what would make times even better? If you were freaking out about this. Good morning, guys, and happy Sunday. Today I want to talk to you a bit about rest and recovery strategies, especially since today is most people's beloved rest day, although sadly this week it is not mine. In this video, I'm going to talk to you guys about my personal recovery strategies as well as my personal experience using CBD from the company Herbstrong. As somebody that works a 9-to-5 job and then trains afterwards and then is also training on the weekends and coaching and programming and running Benji around and being a normal human being on the weekends, recovery at this moment is huge. And if you're taking your training seriously, which I hope that you are, you should be taking your recovery strategies just as seriously too.
Exercise has many benefits, not only for your physical health, but also your mental health. Working out can also help improve sleep, reduce stress, and help reduce symptoms of depression and anxiety. Exercise can affect your mood through the release of endorphins and serotonin from physical activity. Many lifters view weight training as a positive outlet for their mental health. Exercising is another great tool in your overall wellness toolbox.
I'm a former Team USA powerlifter. I compete in bodybuilding now, and I train jiu-jitsu as well. For the last few months, I have been really feeling sluggish. I've had lack of motivation. It was really hard to get my body to get up and do anything. I was able to get my blood work done a couple months ago, and I realized that my cortisol was almost triple the amount that it really should be. Because I've worked so much on my mental health and I have so many skills, I didn't think that cortisol or stress could be the component to why I was feeling so poorly. I've started taking some steps to prioritize stress management, not just as a band-aid, but as a true integration into my life. And man, I've started to feel the best I ever had. I didn't realize how much stress was controlling my life until I was able to look at my blood work. I'm getting my blood work done next week for the first time, really excited to see what my cortisol looks like because I know that there has to be a difference now. And I'm really excited to keep integrating proper stress management tools into my life.
Give me the chop!
So as soon as I tried that out, I could feel tension in my legs, my butt immediately, and that was huge. It changed the rest of my sets for the rest of the day. You might be asking, why is this important then? And I'll tell you in the next story. Hey guys, so in my previous deadlift post, I talked about how I was able to feel my gluteus for the first time in the deadlift. And so I'm gonna explain to you guys the information I know, how I made that click, and how I understand it. So hope this helps. Here we go. I just rewatched that whole thing, and how annoying was it that I said so like 1,000 times? I'm so sorry. So, there are a lot of cues out there, and the way my brain works, not all of them make sense. Until yesterday, it clicked that you need to have 3 points of contact within your feet on all 3 lifts. Got it? We'll move on.